is the land alongside or near a sea or an ocean. It is also called a coastline or seashore. India's coastline stretches up to about 7,500 kilometers. The peninsular part of India has the Arabian Sea to its west, the Bay of Bengal to its east, and the Indian Ocean to its south. The east coast and the west coast meet at the Indian Ocean. The coastal plains comprise the western coastal plains and the eastern coastal plains and islands. Western coastal plains. The western coastal plains form a strip of land lying between the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea. The western coastal plains begin in Gujarat at the Gulf of Kutch, going southward through the western parts of Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka and Kerala, right up to Kanyakumari, which is the southernmost tip of the Indian mainland. The climate here is hot and humid throughout the year.
The western coastal plains are divided into three main parts: Gujarat or Saurashtra coast, Konkan coast, and Malabar coast.
Gujarat or Saurashtra coast. It is the top part of the western coastal plains. The Gujarat coast starts from the Gulf of Kutch and stretches across till the Gulf of Khambat. A gulf is a narrow inlet of sea partly surrounded by land. This region has very fertile soil, and thus crops like cotton, groundnut, tobacco, wheat, jawar, and bajra grow well here.
Kandla is a major port of this region.
Ahmedabad is famous for its textile industry. Gujarat is a major salt-producing state of the country. Konkan coast. It is the middle part of the western coastal plains. The Konkan coast starts from the Gulf of Khambat and stretches up to Goa. It covers the states of Maharashtra, Goa, and Karnataka. The Konkan coastline is rocky, uneven, and narrow. Therefore, high towers called lighthouses can be seen at certain points along the coast. They warn the ships and other boats of the big rocks in the sea. Rice, coconut, cashew nut, mango, and pineapple are some of the crops grown in this region. Mumbai is the main city of the Konkan region and is located on the Konkan coast. The Mumbai port is a natural harbour and is also India's biggest port. Mumbai is India's commercial capital and a very big trade centre. The Konkan coast is rich in petroleum, which is why many oil wells have been dug here. Crude oil, also called black gold, is found along the Konkan coast. Many wells have been dug near the Mumbai coast to extract oil. You can see an oil well at Mumbai High in the given picture. Margao in Goa is another important port of this coast.
Malabar Coast. As we go further down, we find the Malabar Coast, the southern part of the western coastal plains.
This one is not as rocky as the Konkan Coast.
The Malabar Coast receives heavy rainfall and has a hot and humid type of climate.
The coast is evergreen. The hill slopes have thick forests.
The Malabar coastline
looks even more beautiful, lined with coconut trees all along. We find many lagoons along the Kerala coastline. Lagoons are shallow salt water bodies called ponds and lakes separated from the main sea. These are connected by canals which help in transporting people and goods across the lagoon. People go from one place to another in small boats called ketuvallams. Rice is the main staple food of people living on
the Malabar coast.
Cash crops like coconuts, bananas, cashew nuts, and spices like pepper, cloves, ginger, and cinnamon are grown here. Rubber is also grown here. People work on rubber and coffee plantations or are involved in other agricultural or fishing activities.
Kochi, another natural harbour, is the most important port on the Malabar coast and also has a big shipyard and an oil refinery.
Tourism in the western coastal plains. These plains have some of the best beaches in the country. Most of them are now becoming popular tourist spots. Water sports such as scuba diving and snorkeling are the main attractions in Panaji in Goa and Tarkarli and Harihareshwar in Maharashtra.
Kerala is also a very popular tourist destination on the Malabar coast.
Eastern Coastal Plains. The Eastern Coastal Plains lie between the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal. These plains are wider and leveled as compared to the Western Coastal Plains. The eastern coastal plains begin from West Bengal and pass through Odisha, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. They end at Kanyakumari.
The northern part of the eastern coastal plains is called the Northern Sarkars, while their southern part in the coastline is called the Coromandel Coast.
The Coromandel Coast lies between Kanyakumari and Andhra Pradesh. From here on begin the Northern Sarkars, which move upward right up to West Bengal. The eastern coastal plains consist of the deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari and Krishna that make this tract of land fertile. Rice and sugarcane are grown in this highly fertile region. Additionally, cotton, coconut, and jute are grown in the eastern coastal plains. Chennai and Visakhapatnam are two very important ports. Chennai is one of the largest ports in India. Visakhapatnam is a natural harbor and also has a huge shipbuilding yard and an oil refinery. Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands are a group of islands situated in the Bay of Bengal. They are one of the Union Territories of India. Port Blair is the capital of the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. While rice and coconut are widely grown here, the climate is also suitable for growing pulses, fruits, and vegetables. This territory consists of two distinct groups of islands, Andaman and Nicobar. There are about 572 islands, of which nearly 37 islands are inhabited. Lakshadweep Islands.
The Lakshadweep Islands are located near the Malabar coast in the Arabian Sea. It is a group of about 36 islands and islets with only a few inhabited by people.
They form the smallest Union Territory of India. Like all coastal areas, rice and coconut are the main crops. Lakshadweep grows bananas, edible root crops, and millets. Importance of coastal areas. Coastal regions provide critical inputs for industry, such as space for developing ports for transporting goods, fishing, and other marine activities, and thus provide livelihood to many. Thus, we have learned about the coastal plains of India.